I believe a lot of what entrepreneurs are needed for today is to use technology to solve real world problems. We've sort of said they can be old, they can be young, they can be men, they can be women, they can come from all sorts of backgrounds. So we look at those characteristics, but I think we almost have to get the biases out of the panelists in terms of who looks like a traditional or sounds like a traditional entrepreneur in our minds. Zika and Layla grew up in the slums, the favelas of Rio. They had this idea to create beauty salons that would cater to curly-haired population. They started out in their kitchens with a formula that didn't work, and they kept persisting. And, you know, here it is of these two women who grow up in a situation that you would think, if you're talking about them as entrepreneurs, oh, they must be microcredit entrepreneurs. And like, there is nothing micro about Layla or Zika and Beleza Natural. This is one of the fastest growing companies. They employ thousands of women in their stores. And so I think that that's at the micro level, is shifting our vision of who are entrepreneurs. It's not just young men in black turtlenecks and hoodies in Silicon Valley. It's people like Layla, it's people like Wences, who you wouldn't necessarily associate as entrepreneurs, but are really big thinking entrepreneurs. On the macro level, Endeavor really believes in what we call the big bubble effect, which is entrepreneurs that not only generate employment for their own employees and generate wealth for their shareholders, but people who are giving back into the ecosystem by mentoring others, by serving as angel investors, by being philanthropic, by giving back to the community. And so when we look at our board members around the world, we have Endeavor entrepreneurs that are now serving as board members. They are finding ways to pay it forward, and that's what creates the multiplier effect. So for me, when you talk about cultural change and we look at places where Endeavor is not, you see one, two, or three success stories that don't give back, and their stories stop there. And so what we try to do is say, no, if you want to have systemic change, you can't just worry about your own success in your own company. You have to find ways to pay it forward to multiply that influence. So we really look at, once they become Endeavor entrepreneurs, what are the customized plans that each entrepreneur, it's different, needs to get to the next level? Is it access to markets? Is it access to capital? Is it access to executive training? And Endeavor provides all of those things, but each entrepreneur decides what individually or collectively is going to help them get to the next level. So Endeavor is now in 32 countries around the world. In the US, we're now in 6 cities. We're about to launch in Western New York, in Buffalo and Rochester. And we have screened 60,000 entrepreneurs, and we're working with just under 2,000 entrepreneurs. Not only are they generating, next year they will be on track to generate over 2 million jobs, and they're generating $15 billion in annual revenue that keeps increasing. But what's important to me is that 2/3 of the revenues and 3/4 of the jobs come after their affiliation with Endeavor. I think that that's what I love to do, give people permission not only to think big, but think differently and look at those spaces that no one's looked at before.